Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to the Faculty Development Program. Myself, Ishan Upadhyay, would like to extend a very warm welcome to the fifth and last day and last session of the FDP on Modern Educational Tools and Pedagogical Practices for Online Teaching, organized by Vidyalankar Institute of Technology. It is very important for online educators to make interactive videos. Interactive videos not only enable online educator to make teaching learning process more enjoyable and engaging, but also brings flexibility and convenience in learning. So, to understand how to make interactive videos using H5P, we have Professor Ajita Deshmukh with us. Professor Ajita Deshmukh is a passionate chemistry educator keen towards making quality chemistry education accessible and fun. She currently works as assistant professor at ICT with the School of Education and Research, MIT ADT University, Pune, India, where she trains pre-service teachers. She is also a course developer for OER 4DW, that is Open Education for Better World, a UNESCO project by University of Nova Gorica, Slovenia. She has previously worked as assistant professor ICT at CIET, NCERT, and as a training coordinator at Teaching Learning Center, SNDT Women's University, Mumbai. Her areas of interest are online education, particularly open education, and specialists in social media in education. Once again, on behalf of Vidyalankar family, I extend a very warm welcome, Ajita Madam. Without any further delay, I request our speakers to address our delegate. Thank you.
Namaskar, everybody. I hope you are able to hear me. And I know that it's afternoon post lunch, but therefore we have some immersive work for us. So we are going to actually do some interactivity in the videos. Now, how do we do this is by using a package which is called as H5P package, which stands for HTML5. Now, I am going to do complete demonstration, and I would really like everybody to have a say in this. So first of all, how would you be actually ask that our videos are interactive or not? What would we do so that we can have interactive videos? Feedbacks, okay. I just want a few people to comment. I'm just waiting for that. How would we expect interaction to be? If I'm going to send my video out, how will I know that the students are actually interacting with the video and they have just not kept it open and then they are doing something else? How do we do that? Okay, we can have a poll. Very nice. Thank you, Dr. Sanjay. Yes, poll is one way. What if I can ask a fill in the blank? Comments. Okay. We can ask students to comment, but where will we ask the students to comment? So if we are going to ask the students to comment, then either we need to put it with the WhatsApp or then we have to go YouTube. But I don't want to go on YouTube, but I still want to ensure that my students have actually watched the video. Poll, quiz, add quiz, chat, yes. So can we have something else? So there are something around say 30, yes, 30. Activities that we can design and develop using H5P. Now, what all are the things that we can have? So let's just quickly think of all sorts of things that we can do. Okay. We can have fill in the blanks. Yes. We can ask true or false. Yes. We can ask quiz, MCQ. Yes. What else? Can we ask a memory game? Yes. Can we ask an essay type of question? Yes. Can we have something more? Yes, so all of it and much more. So it's not possible for me to show all 30 things that are there in H5P, but yes, it's a fantastic tool and you are going to enjoy it once you start exploring it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share the screen and I'm going to go directly on the demonstration. Just before that, what I would like to know to for you all to know is you have to create an account there. Okay, just with a normal email ID that you have to create your account and password and whatever. So I have already logged in. Now, why I'm telling you this is because just to save time, I've already logged in. This is a free and open source software. So the banners at the top, you can actually put your college ka banner or your own personal banner and personalize it. So all of that is possible. Yes, puzzles, crosswords, yes, all of it can be done. So let's go to learning H5P and I'm going to share my screen now. So once you create your login and account, what you're going to see is something like this. I'm going to just give me a couple of seconds while I share the screen. Yes. So this is my screen, which I hope everybody is able to see. And this is how it looks like. So this is my login name and I should go to my own part first. So what I see is the moment I log in, of course I have enlarged this. So what I see is I see quick links. The first one is try out H5P, where you can try out H5P. And we have so many of the content that I have made. You can also see that I am a member of H5P for 2 years and 5 days. And you can see that so many of them are already there. And you can see demo 1, demo 8 and all that. These are all prepared for the demonstration purpose. So now what all can I do in this? So let me just take you to the contents part first. And let me just have you walk through what all things we can do. So as you see that this is my profile and I can edit my profile. Now these are the contents. The contents that we can create. Now, one decently slow, and I'm going to take a few of the most important interactive elements that we can take. So first step first. First is we create our login account and we enter. Once we enter, we can change our profile and do all that we want to do with our profile normally that we do. I have avoided it. Doesn't matter. Now we have something called as edits, we have something called as contents, and we have got something called as comments. Now we are going to start creating new content first. And I was being told that we are supposed to understand, or rather we are supposed to, I'm supposed to demonstrate here making of interactive video. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to do this, but at the same time, I have kept one video uploaded and ready, which we will be editing. So let me first start here. This will give you a glimpse of what all things we can do in interactive content in H5P. Now see this, all content types, how many do we see here? 30, 30. Yes, we can create 30 types of interactives. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you to the entire list and just run you through that, what all things we can do. It is mind-boggling and it is fantastic at the same time. So accordion, agamotto. Now see, create vertically stacked expandable items. They are all very self-explanatory things. What happens in accordion is you click on one particular part and it opens up. Okay, then here we can show the before and after ka image. And there are fantastic content creation types. We can create collages, we can have course presentation is a big brother of PowerPoint is what I can say. It has got fantastic types of different types of animation effects in that. Dialogue cards, it's something like flashcards that you can have. We have documentation tool, we have drag and drop, drag the words and so on and so forth. So what are we actually going to do now? So I'm going to take you to the popular first and I'm going to take the interactive video. Because we are going to actually see how to create a video, an interactive one. So details. So here are the content demos that you can have, and I am going to create my own. But before we are going to create our own, I would just like you to see what actually happens when we are doing this. Okay, so how is an interactive video seen? The interactive video, it's seen something like this. And I know that you people have had your lunch. So I think you should be able to survive the hunger pangs if you get. We can have this type of quizzes in between the video. So that's what we are going to do actually now. And we are going to create new content. And I am going to take the interactive video. So I'm not seeing the details now. I am picking up the interactive video. So it has picked up. Now I want to have the title here. So what I will be doing is I will say demo for VIP. Okay. Now I am going to have to upload a video, or I can also share the link of it. So I will just add it here. If I have my own video made, I can upload my video file, or I can just copy paste a video source or a YouTube link, taking care of the Creative Commons license, whether I am allowed to do that or not. Now, just remember that the upload limit is only 16 MB. So I can just copy paste my YouTube link here, and then I will be clicking insert. Now, for the sake of saving of the time, I have already done this, and this looks something like this. Okay, so we see that I have picked up a TED-Ed video here, and the TED-Ed video is in place. I just hope that this much is clear. Now, if you see this, there is one circle here, another circle here. These circles are the points where I have inserted interactivity, and we are going to see how to add interactivity more. So I'm just going to switch on this particular video, and of course I'm going to put off the audio of this, and let's see, and I'm going to run it. Okay, so I'm putting the sound off, and let's see what happens when we go ahead. So the moment it reaches there, you will see a pop-up coming here. And what is that pop-up asking? Fill in the missing words. Okay. Now we know that we haven't seen the video. So let's say in the brain, I'm going to give purposely wrong answers. In the brain, nerves deals with word analysis. And then I am going to ask to check. Oh, one of my answers is wrong and only one is right. Okay, so I have to retry. See, I can't see show solutions here. So if I could have seen the show solutions, then I could have been able to see what are the answers here. But I haven't allowed it. So can we do that? Yes, we can do that. Let's go ahead and see, can the students skip this? Well, one is answered. If you see, it came just now here. And I have allowed my student to, you know, escape this particular part. And again, let me just run through it quickly, because all we are interested in is to learn how to put the interaction. Okay. So once it comes here, again, it is going to stop and ask me for the next question. So, because this video talks about dyslexia, now let's see. Which of the following statements is true about dyslexia? I hope you all have noticed that the first one was a fill in the blank, while the second question is an MCQ. So, what does this tell us? That we can mix and merge all different types of questions to make our video interactive. After all, it is boring, right? To see the same type of question also coming up. Okay, so here we have an MCQ. So, yeah, it's an afternoon time, so let's just make it easier. Which of the following statements is true about dyslexia? Okay, that dyslexia affects only men. Is it true? Let's see whether it is true or not. I would just request you all to remember the order in which the answers are. Okay, Now let's see what happens. Oh, it's wrong. And see, the way in which we have adjusted here is also different. In the previous question, there was no I symbol here. But now in this question, we have. Okay, so I'm going to retry. This is my retry option. So I came to know that dyslexia doesn't affect only men. It can also affect women. So let me retry. Now, if the student is, see if you can notice, the order is changed. So there is this particular tendency, you know, of the students to ask each other, hey, what's the correct answer? And maybe the person says that, oh, and the first answer is the correct answer. And I may not be paying attention here and I may just mark, you know, A as the answer or B as the answer. And then we never know that the students have really studied or not, or even read or not. But this takes care of it. It always shuffles. It shuffles automatically and you can set that setting. So dyslexia may be genetic. Let's check. Oh, yes. So now I can continue. Now if I am going to continue, but what if I would have given the answer wrong? Do I want to retry this? So I can't go back. Okay, I can go only ahead. And you can see that there was a particular star that I got. Now, how do I add extra interactions here? That is the part what we are going to see in today's demonstration. What we are going to do now is we are going to go to the edit option. Remember, I have kept the choice of the same video. I have not gone back to my profile. This is still the same video that is running and I was viewing it just now to demonstrate. Now I will go on edit. So if I'm going to go on edit, so what things have changed? Oh, let's see. So what is this is, once you paste the link, you should get something like this. Okay. After that, our step two is add interactions. Now for adding interactions, we need to view something. So let's pop on our video and let's try to see what the video tries to say after this interaction. And let's try to frame a question. And I'm going to put on the sound and hopefully you all should be able to give me a question for that. So the first thing that I would like to see is that the brains show difference in structure and function. Okay, so that is my one point where I can insert a question here, an interaction here. It could be the reflection spot where I want my students to reflect upon. So now I'm going to ask a question here. So how do I do that? Now I have stopped it. We need to stop the video where we have to insert the question. Once we do it, now see the amount of options we have got here. Okay. Now these are all those options of those 30. Out of those 30, what all things can we add here? Now we have already seen one fill in the blank type of a question. We have also seen one multiple choice of question. So let's try to add one true and false type of a question. And then we go ahead and we try something more. So we put up a true or false question here. And yes, so pause the video. That means if I'm going to select this, the video will pause. It will not go ahead. If I don't click this and if the students do not stop it themselves, then the video will continue to run. So I'm going to pause the video here. That is, my video will be paused and the question will pop up. Now, how do I know that the question is being popped out? Either I choose a button or I choose a poster. I don't like the poster because it occupies most of the screen. What I prefer is a button, the way in which you were able to see that small hand there with a raised hand in purple color. So I'm just going to keep that button itself. Now, what is going to be my label? And then comes my untitled true-false question, which of course I will give it a title. Now here, this label, I am going to just write. Stop and think, or maybe let's write reflect. or I'm going to add reflection spot. And this is going to prompt my other questions which are going to come forward. So I am going to just replace this untitled by just saying again, it's an RS question, or you may give the title as per whatever you wish to. Now, my question here is, I can't have a straightforward question, then it will be very boring. So what I would like people to do is, I may just like them to think and talk. So I'm going to type something. Hello. I am going to talk. I'm going to type that, what is the difference in the brain diagrams observed? Okay. So, but it's a true and false question. So I can't say what is the difference. So I'll just say, is there any difference? And now my answer is going to be true. So it is already labeled as true. So once you do this, my correct answer is either true or false. It is true. I go to the behavioral settings. Now here comes how strict I want to be. If I want my students to retry, then yes, I can put this up. If I don't want my students to retry, I'll not allow them to retry. But here I'm trying to be a little bit lenient. I don't want my solution to be seen, then I will not click this. But right now it's just a true and false question, so it's fine. Now, show confirmation dialogue on check or on retry or automatically check the answer, because H5P is a plugin to almost all the LMSs, especially Moodle. So you can link it to the Moodle and it will automatically then check your answer. So what should be the feedback on the correct answer? So I will just say, well done. And feedback on the wrong answer would be, watch the video again. Something of that sort. Okay. And then we go down. You can also change its adaptivity, that what action you want to take, if it is all correct, all wrong. I can also tick mark this and ensure that my students get that much mark and then proceed ahead with the video. But I would suggest that if this is only for the sake of interaction, then not to make it so very difficult for students to go ahead. Otherwise, it becomes quite frustrating. Now, this interaction is done, so I'll click on done. But yet, I have to go down again. And you will see now that initially when I showed the video, you had only two dots, two circles. Now, the third circle is also there, and you can already see this coming up. But I still have to do one step, and that is to save this. If it there is no auto save, so you have to keep on saving it. Okay, now you may create more content. So it has given you a green signal, and let's see whether it really works or not. I'm still having to do a lot of things to work with H5P, so why should I rate it just now? Now let's see how it works. So I'm going to skip this from here because we are interested in what we have actually created. So let's see, let's watch. See, so because I had kept it as pause the video got automatically paused and I can't go ahead. Okay. So, well, let me check out. False. Let's see. See, this is what we had given, right? Watch the video again. So I'm going to have retry and true and check. Well done. Yes. And so we are going to continue this. And now that's how we insert a particular, what can we say, particular interaction. Now there will be lots of questions here that how does it get graded? Does it get added to the grade book and all? Yes, it gets added to the grade book because it's a plugin, like I have already said. Let's see if something else as an interaction can be added. So let's watch the video and let's see if we can have some questions coming from you, that what type of a question would you want here? Okay. So there was this particular part where there is something called as norm, and there are so many people who are brilliant and yet dyslexic. So can we have something like, we can have one more interaction here, and let me go to the edit, and by the time it picks up the entire part, let's see if you want to give your feedback on how you can have, you know, your question here. And I can see the question that, can we upload our own video? Yes, of course, we can upload our own video. Let me just get back there if you all want. Or should we see one more? Let's add one more interaction and then I'll show you how to upload our own video. Okay. So we are just adding one more interaction here. And now we have already done a fill in the blank. We have already done true and false. And we have also done one multiple choice. So let's see if we can have mark the words. Okay, let's have that. Okay, so here again, I am going to ask to pause the video. And yes, this also can be adjusted. If you would have noted that my video went ahead, but that reflection spot, that hand was still there. That was because it was going to be there for next 10 seconds. Okay. So I can always adjust this. I can reduce this to 5 seconds. I can increase it to 12 seconds and whatever you wish to. The button will be there. And yeah, the label. So now let's check. I'm just going to add something like, let's check. And mark the words. So I am just going to write personalities because there were some personalities there. So how is the user supposed to solve the task? Now I want the my student to have to mark the correct word. So what I will write is mark the correct personality or mark the correct words that show a personality, famous personality. You know, this is just for the sake of demonstration. We obviously have to frame very good questions for this. Now let's see. The H5P software tells us what we are supposed to do. So this is the same instruction that is given even when we are doing our fill in the blanks. So we have to mark what particular word has to be marked by the students. So if I'm going to write here that Einstein was brilliant and dyslexic, but I am neither. Okay, so I'm just having fun at my own expense. So now, because my question says that pick up the words or mark the words which have famous personality. Now Einstein is a famous personality, so I am going to put an asterisk there before the word of the person and after the word of the person. So that is the reason why I always say that if the software doesn't go wrong, the people who make it and the people who create the content also can go wrong. So if I do this, then I'm saying that I am famous, which I'm not. So it becomes it becomes the part of the teacher to be very cautious of what is being instructed and what is seen. Okay, so here I have score range. Now, since I have only one word, I need to have only 0 to 100% then, but I would like to have something more. So what I'll do is Einstein and Picasso were brilliant. So I need to have Picasso as well under the asterisks. And let me just do this and let's see what happens. Okay, now let me put my score. So if only one of the answer is correct, so I'll just put 0 to 50% and I'll say, go to the video again. And if it's complete 100%, then, well, I have given three words, so I'll give it something more. So I'll put here 75% and I'll say, can do better. And then for the last, I'll say, well done. I can also choose distribute evenly, which I usually don't choose for my own reasons. Now, behavior settings, I don't want to have show solution button, but I want to show the score points. So, done. And what are we missing out? We are missing out on saving. But if you can see here, I need to first save. So let's hope that our interaction is there. So, I don't think it has come. Let me just check. How did I know that it has not come? Because I can't see the fourth circle here. So maybe it has not. Let us just go to the edit option and check why is it that it has not been added there. So let's see, add interactions. And let's take the cursor ahead. And do we have the interaction there? Let's just check. If it's not, then we will add. If it's not there, then we will add again. So we must have not done all the steps at that particular time. Yes. Okay, so our interaction was not added. So let's add it again. So we are going to do, okay, we will have drag and drop option. And we are going to choose the pause video option here. And then the button is there as it is. And I don't want to add any image here. Okay, so drag and drop is used for images, so I can't use the drag and drop part. So I need to go back. So what I'll be doing is I'll just go back to the video and yes, I'll again play it and I'll bring it till here. I go to the, yes. So now what we will do is we'll go back to edit. And in the edit part, we are supposed to add interactions. And where are we adding the interaction? We are going to add it here. Yeah, I also found out my mistake. So the mistake that was there is I did not see the time when we had chosen. So our fourth interaction went to the first interaction. So that's the mistake that we did. So we need to remove that afterwards. And we will do mark the words. And let me just check. Yes, now I can see the display time is correct. I'll put it as pause video. And we'll put it here as personalities. And then again here also, as we will mark the famous personality. And task description is going to be click on or mark the names of the famous personalities in the text. So just go down. Oh yes, I need to take care of the spellings, because in audiovisual medium, even a simple small spelling mistake is just blown out of proportion. So now here, like we did earlier, we are going to write our text and mark with an asterisk before and after. Einstein and Picasso were brilliant and dyslexic, but I am neither. And like we said, we are going to choose a wrong word also, just to see that how it works. And then we have add a range. And since we have only two answers here, or rather three answers here, I'm going to have the first one here and view again. Then we have add range. 75%, okay, 65 means 75. And here we have can do better. I'm a strict teacher, right? Yeah. Okay, but who's wrong here? The teacher's wrong, huh? Why? Because I'm also writing I as a famous personality, which I'm not. So the teacher needs to be careful what I'm actually asking my students to do. Now, behavioral settings, I am not going, okay, I can allow them to retry, but I'm not going to allow them to see the solution. And then I do done. Once I do it, I should be able to see that spot here, whether it is added or not. Yes, it is. And then we go ahead and we save it. Once we save, only then our work is over, not before that. So now let's see if whatever we have done works or doesn't. And let's have fun at my cost. Yes. So I'm going to have it started. And I'm going to again just run through till here. Okay. Okay. Okay, so because we had chosen pause the video, we got this. So this is where I'm going to click. My question pops up and mark the names of the famous personalities. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, see if you see the boxes move. So the student or anybody can just click it here. Now, if I'm that particular type of a student who just mindlessly is going to, you know, click all the words. Oh my God, I just hope nobody gets that type of students, but still. Okay. I'm just doing like alternate words and then see what happens. Oh, so I come to know which of my words are correct, which of them are wrong, as per the answer key. I also can, as a student, I will just object to this particular question, that how is I the famous person, because your question said mark the famous personalities and this was not there. So, you know, the teacher has to be very careful about what the teacher wants to actually ask the students. Now I can retry or I can go ahead as well. Now in this particular case, I had allowed the video to be continued. Even if my answer is wrong, I can still continue it. But yes, you can always stop that from the adaptive settings and the behavioral settings. So that is how we actually make the video interactive. I'm going to stop the screen share for a moment so that I can see and talk to you all about the few questions that I have received that I would like to take. Okay, so the first question was that can we upload our own videos? Yes, we can, provided that they are lesser than 16 MB. Also, can we clip and pick up only certain videos is what the other questions are that are coming to me. And yes, we can clip certain part of the video. And of course, we'll need some video editor for that. We can compress the video, we can cut it, and then we can upload it. As long as it is in 16 MB, I guess it should be fine for us. So again, should we go back to making the interactive video and seeing something else, or is there anything else that need to be taken? Is it possible to draw structures in organic chemistry and upload in quiz? Yes, it is possible. I'll just take you there to one of the quizzes that I already have. It's not a quiz, it's a game. It's a memory game. So we are now not going only on the videos, but also we are seeing what type of games we can make. And that is a chemistry game. Of course, it's made for, I guess, standard 12 or something. Can you please guide on how to amalgamate quiz and clip from H5P and include in PPT? Okay, in the PPT, instead of that, why don't we choose create presentation, create interactive presentation in H5P, and then we can do all of it. So let's go to that. That's a very interesting thing that we can learn. So let me just share the screen and we will create an interactive presentation. And yes, I'll show you how to have a particular diagram and use it for, you know, constructive method of teaching science. Yeah, lot of chemistry coming up. Okay, so by the time the screen gets shared, I have some particular content already developed for the purpose of demo. So I'm just going to take you back to my own account here. And we will just see what all things I have and which can be beneficial for you. So these are all sorts of contents that have been created. And because somebody talked about the game, I think I do have one memory game. Yes. So I'll show you this particular thing that we have done. Okay. Now this is that plain, simple, old, you know, Tash Ka Patta, where we have this playing cards and we just flip them and match them and combine them. So see, let's see what we have done. Okay, copper. Now this is going to be randomized. So the next time I pick this, okay, so this was my copper and magnesium. No, this is my copper and this is copper. So the moment it is correct, you'll see that it becomes gray. Okay. So yes, this is how you can also have a particular set of memory type of game. This is magnesium. Is it? Yes, it is. So I know my chemistry. Okay. So, and if you see down, you will also see that how many cards did I turn and how much of the time it spent in getting this particular game. So this can be an insight to me as a teacher that who's taking more time and is it just going at random or is it following some logic. Another one that I can show you is, actually, you would like to also see something like how to have diagrams was one of the questions. So I just hope that I can get you across to the blast furnace thing that I had. And Yes. So many of them are there. Yes. Yes, I have the blast furnace. And what I had done is, this is straightway from a textbook, from the class 12 textbook, and I have just added spots here. Now, if you have ever taught, and if you were like me as a student, if you were like me, then when the teacher is showing a particular diagram, my mind will wander off to some other place also when the teacher is explaining one particular part. So how do I tackle that then? I give this to the students as a self-paced learning. And the students then actually label, open up the label and see what is written on the label and learn according to that, whatever I mark. And then in my class, I can ask the students that, why is it that this difference of colors you see? What is the difference between the wall, the bricks used in the wall, and the bricks used somewhere else? So this can lead to a very good type of a discussion here. And students can learn the mark and label and draw the diagrams and all that thing at their own pace. So even this is possible in H5P. And there was one more question of create presentation that we are going to do just now. Let's try that. It's fun. Okay. So here, recent content, and I'm going to content, and I'm going to create new content. And see what we are going to choose. I have very less time, but I'm going to choose course presentation. And I request everybody to be attentive here, because this is the fun part of it, because the only place where you can have a mix of questions in the slides. Now, these are the slides. Okay. So this is actually like a PowerPoint, and I can put in any image, video, any shape, or I can even put insert in hyperlink to it. Okay. So if I have an image, I can put it. If I have a video, I can upload it, but possibly to put a YouTube link, that is better. Now, I'm not going to put up any image or anything. I'm just going to show you that, can I put a fill in the blank on one slide and something else on the other. Now, since we are running out of time, what I'm going to do is, I'm not going to fill up this untitled fill in the blank. I'm just going to remove the untitled part, and then we go to fill in the missing words. Let it be like that. Now I'm going to write here, it is very hot today. Again, like we said earlier, that we have to put a asterisk mark. So we are going to put an asterisk mark here. That settles it. And again, I'm just going to have only one, as I want it to be. And this, because we have already done it, I'm not spending too much of time on it. And yes, I can always have display comments, display as a button, and I'm just going to do done. So see what I'm getting. I'm getting a display button here, and I'm going to have to edit this, so, because I don't want it to be seen as a display button. So I want it as a big thing, and here. So we have this on our slide. Now I can just increase it. I can shift it. You know, I can place it anywhere I want to place it in the slide. I can also change the background color of the slide and all that. Yes, everything of that sort can be done. Whatever you want to do, you can do. But what I'm more interested in is to create a resource which will have a lot of variety of interaction, which will keep my students alert. So my first one is missing words. Now I'm going to have add a slide, and I'm going to add another interaction. So what I'm going to do is, this is drag text. This is very interesting. So I'm going to just have drag text. And yeah, drag the words in the correct box is my instruction that is going to be there. And again, so here I'm going to type my chemistry. Forgive for my chemistry part, and if it goes wrong, okay. So here it is, blast furnace is used to extract iron, molten iron is obtained. So, and this molten iron is going to be impure. So, I'm just going to write it as it is impure iron. Now, where are my words that I want to be dragged? So, I'm going to say that this is my blast. Okay, I'm going to use blast furnace as one word. I'm also going to have molten iron. I'm only going to take molten. And I'm also going to take a impure. And then again, for the score, yes, I have 3. So I'm going to put up 50. And I'll just say, read the content. I'll just add something and it goes to 75. And I'll say, can do better. And then here I'll say, well done. And then what do we have to do? We have to save it after doing done. So once we do this done part, then we come to the adjustment of it and see how the words are placed below. And once we save it, we have our resource ready. Oh, I need to have a title here. So I'm going to put demo VIT2. It won't otherwise save. And remember that all the resources that are put up on the H5P site are open for all. This is a free and open source software. So all the resources that you do are visible to everybody. Now let's see how does this appear to the students. So it is very, if I put cold, let's see what happens. Oh, it's wrong. And it doesn't even allow me to go ahead because I had not picked it that way. So I'm going to just say show solution and retry. Okay, so I'm going to have hot here, tech, done. Now, once I get that star mark, I will go ahead with the next slide. And I'm going to just drag and drop the words impure, molten, and blast furnace. Now, see, as teachers, we need to understand that if I'm going to put one as a small alphabet, that itself is giving out the hint. So please be careful that not to give such subtle hints. But right now, for the demonstration purpose, it's okay. So only one of the answer is correctly placed. The others are not. I could have stopped this and I'm going to have retry. So let me have. Oh, okay. I remembered that this is not the correct one. This is check. So this is how my students have scored it. Now what, as a teacher, what do I get here? See, this is, you get it in the third slide. That is the summary slide. That what is the total, how many marks did the student actually get, and all the other things. This will also be added to the grade book of your Moodle. Also, I would just like to show you, I'll take you back to the video that we saw just now, only for the purpose of seeing that how do we get the analytics of interactive videos. You can always copy the link and share it with your students if you don't want your LMS to be in function. Okay, we don't want to test the students constantly, right? Sometimes it is just good to have only interaction. So what happens once you reach to the end of the slide? You get a summary card. So once you do this, see, you'll get a summary card here if it is attached. Actually, you should get it here just now also. Let's see. Yeah. So because in this particular run, I did not answer any of the questions, I'm getting the answer as you have not answered any questions and you have to answer at least one question to submit the answer. If I would have answered a question, let's just try and see what happens. Okay. Here. So if I'm going to choose this as the answer, and I'm going to go right now. So I got 2 marks, and let's see what happens to my scorecard. So here, see, now I got 2 out of 3, and I can submit my answer. So that's how you can add the interactions here. And there are lots and lots of things that you can do with H5P. 30 types of interactions. So please share the link of the YouTube in the group if possible. Okay. Yes. So I just hope that this should help you and enable you to have lots of interactions possible. And yes. Any other questions? I just have 2 minutes before I leave. Not even 2 now. Yes. And I hope you just keep on playing with H5P. It's a wonderful tool.
Yes, I think you have answered all the questions, madam, during session only.
Yes.
So, very good afternoon to everyone present here. I'd like to thank our speaker, Professor Ajita Deshmukh Madam, for such a wonderful session. It has truly been a very interesting session. We are getting very positive reply from our participants. On behalf of the entire first year fraternity and on my very own behalf, I extend a very hearty vote of thanks to Professor Ajita Deshmukh Madam for sharing with us your opinion. Thank you, Madam. I would also wholeheartedly thank all the delegates for their active participation. On that note, I would request all to fill in the feedback form for this session, which is available in the chat box. Along with that, I would also request you all to fill overall feedback form for this FTP. Thank you all participants. Dear participants, yesterday we had requested you to share any novel idea in preparation of an educational video, PPTs, storytelling, quiz, online resources which are not covered in the FTP. We have received few videos, but considering availability of time, we have decided to show few best videos. I request FDP coordinator Professor Ambadas Deshmukh to play those videos.
हेलो अमादा सर, अमादा सर, व्हेन यू शेयर द योर स्क्रीन एट द बॉटम लेफ्ट कॉर्नर यू विल सी दैट अ ऑडियो ऑप्शन कम्स, यू कैन पुट इट ऑन. हेलो,
हाँ आवाज आ रहा है क्या? मेरे पास चल रहा है.
यस नो सर, बट वी कैन नॉट हियर द वॉइस हियर.
हेलो
हेलो, सर यू कैन कैंसिल योर शेयर स्क्रीन नाउ. नाउ अगेन यू कैन स्टार्ट योर शेयर स्क्रीन. प्लीज स्टॉप इट एंड देन अगेन स्टार्ट.
अब देखो आते हैं क्या? अब आ रहे हैं क्या?
So there is no voice coming. Sir, when you start the share screen option,
मैडम का वीडियो है वो प्ले करता है. हाँ ठीक है, ऑल राइट.
हॅलो, हा सर, तिथे तुम्ही ज्या स्क्रीन ते डाउनलोड करून ऑन करा. हो तिथं आता काय करायचं, नेक्स्ट काय करायचं? हा
Hello everyone, there is a slight delay, please bear with us. I'd request all to fill in the feedback form for this session, which is available in chat box. Along with that, I'd also request you to fill overall feedback form. There are two separate feedback forms. One is for today's session and next is overall feedback form for this FTP. I request all of you to fill this feedback form. Dear participants, yesterday we had requested you to share any novel idea in participation of educational videos, but somehow due to some technical issue, we are unable to play those videos. So now we are going to share, we have already shared a link where you all can share your views, and based on that, we have got huge amount of responses, and we are really very happy that our participants have responded to our FDP so positively. We have selected few participants who can come and share their thoughts in front of you all. Over to you, sir.
Hello, Selvi madam, please unmute your mic. Hello, Selvi madam. Hello, Selvi madam. Ma'am, it's not audible. Hello, Sitoshi sir.
Hello.
Hello, sir, you can continue.
Can I continue? Hello.
Yes, sir, you can continue now.
Yes. Okay. I will continue. Many thanks for this faculty development program. I want to thank to Vidyalankar Institute of Technology and team of Ambadas sir and his colleagues. Great work in this faculty development program. At right time we got the right content. That is the main advantage. And what is the outcome of this entire workshop, 5 days workshop? Everyone is participating with a very great interest. Lot of interaction is happening. And personally, from my side, when I want to discuss the outcome, my confidence level related to the online teaching is very much increased. That is the main advantage what I found. I have learned many tools for the online learning. Many web links I have found, many websites were shared during this entire session. That was a really great resource we got it. As well as most important thing is open educational resources, then Creative Commons license, all these things also we learned a lot. And most important thing is what we came to know that about the research in the online education and how the Ganganese 9 even principles also can be adapted using in this online teaching. And from the first day I have started creating the notes of for this faculty development program, and now I can confidently say that I have many slides with me and I can practice in my day-to-day life for online teaching. And I have also decided to write a research paper based upon what I have learned during this faculty development program. Once again, I want to thank you, Vidya Alankar team, Vidya Alankar Institute of Technology and organizing committee. Many, many thanks for this. Thank you.
Hello. Yes, sir. Can I start?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah, okay. Good evening. I am Dr. R. Geeta, Principal, SDNB Vaishnav College for Women, Chennai. It is an aided autonomous college, arts and science college, affiliated to University of Madras with 6,500 students. So the five-day faculty development program conducted by VIT is an eye-opener for me to develop an effective and systematic approach for online teaching, starting from the need for change in teaching pedagogy post-COVID, to the features of online teaching like usage of online tools for content development, then assessment tools, use of OER and importance of Creative Commons license, interactive PPTs, interactive videos, how to give effective assignments, virtual labs, etc. Almost all the sessions were power-packed. The experience of the resource persons from MathWorks, Cypher Schools, Career Labs added flavor to the program. It gives an insight for student engagement effectively using the various tools which are available online. So the takeaway for me from this is that the infrastructure support an institution has to provide to the faculty for online delivery of content and training faculty to adapt to all these technology, which is also the need of the hour. I thank the organizers for effectively organizing the entire sessions and the reach is pan India. I think all of us have got something else to take, some useful tips to take back home. As a head of the institution, the importance is that I can now impart the knowledge which I have gained from this particular FDP program, which was spar on, which was very, very excellent, and see how I translate all the tools which I have learned to my faculty back in Chennai. So I just want to quote Mr. Sai Kiran Dudhyala, plan, prepare, practice and perform. So it was excellently said, and we faculty have to see to it that whatever we have learned from these sessions should not be forgotten in these 5 days. How we put them into action in the rest of the days, that is what we have to do. That is the biggest thing which we can do for VIT Mumbai also. So really, I thank the organizers for a wonderful opportunity, and I'm very, very confident that I can make many more innovations back in my college to all the faculty. All the resource persons were all well chosen, and it was a very great opportunity for us. But for this COVID, we would not have got this exposure also. And I really thank everybody also. And last but not the least, the IIDE session, which was which happened today morning, it was very excellent. And I wish to see how I can just follow them up and see how I can conduct workshops to my students back in my college. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much for the opportunity. Thank you.
Ma'am, Selvi ma'am, you are still not audible. Hello. Selvi ma'am, not audible yet. Hello, Selvi ma'am. Ma'am, you can remove the headphones and Selvi, ma'am. Hello. Hello, Selvi, ma'am. प्लीज अनम्यूट मैम. नो नो मैम. Ishan, you may continue.
Okay. Now, I'd like to call first year engineering in charge, Professor Sonali Borkar Madam, to give overview of FDP. Over to you, Madam.
Good evening, friends. This is Professor Sonali Borkar, in charge first year engineering at Vidya Alankar Institute of Technology. I'm extremely glad to converse with all the teachers from all over India on this online platform of FDP, Modern Educational Tools and Pedagogical Practices for Online Teaching. That's the beauty of the online platform, where the connect happens without the boundary of distance. As we have come to an end, I ponder whether it is an end or is it a new beginning? A beginning to keep ourselves matched the expectations of tech-savvy millennial generation. In the last 5 days, we have gathered various tools from the Pandora box to create our own toolkit for online teaching. All these preparations will benefit our student community in the best possible way, as we foresee plenty of online teaching in the near future. I would like to share something with you all. When we started planning for this FDP, the scope was just limited to my department faculty. But our futuristic management, who always thinks ahead of time, motivated us to make this FDP open for all, as the knowledge is for sharing and it is priceless. Our Vidya Alankar motto is students first. And we get lot of support in each and everything in the benefit of the students and staff who are treated as family by our chairperson, Ms. Rashmi Deshpande, our trustee, Mr. Vishwas Deshpande, and director, Mr. Milind Tadvalkar. I'm sincerely grateful to our management on behalf of FE department. I sincerely thank our principal, Dr. Patekar sir, our vice principal, Professor Varsha Bhosle, chief academic officer, Dr. Saurabh Mehta, and all the head of the departments for their support in planning and execution of this FDP. We wholeheartedly appreciate the generosity of the renowned speakers, as they have agreed to share their expertise with all of us without charging us anything. It is said that one good turn deserves another. And so, as a way of giving back to the teaching fraternity, we have also offered this FDP completely free of cost to all the participants. We request you all to take the knowledge ahead. I take this opportunity to appreciate my own team. I thank Professor Deshmukh for crafting the entire program and getting relevant speakers with the help of Professor Krishna. I would like to pat the back of my onstage team, Professor Manish, Anahita, Mickey, and Ishan for making the program flawless. And also my backstage team, Professor Rupesh, Nasir, Nilima, Mitali, Praveen, and Kashit sir for handling the battle behind the scenes. I can't forget Professor Meenakshi Nandula, who is the backbone of this FDP, was guiding at each and every step to make this FDP a success. And finally, you all delegates. We were delighted to see the FDP was very participative due to enthusiastic response in the chat box and other forums. You all took out time also from your busy schedule. Aap sabka tehe dil se shukriya. Our Prime Minister has appealed to us for Atmanirbhar Bharat. And I think we teachers need to be self-reliant to make the new generation more capable. And to do that, I would like to end this session with Bill Gates' quote, "Technology is merely a tool." In terms of getting the kids to work together and motivate them, teacher is the most important. With this, I take your leave. Take care. Be safe. Bye-bye.
I request all participants to wait for 7 days. Within 7 days, we will mail certificate to you. Now, finally, I would like to call FDP coordinator, Professor Ambadash Deshmukh sir, to give vote of thanks. Over to you, sir.
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of the entire Vidyalankar Institute of Technology family, and on my very own behalf, I extend a very hearty vote of thanks to all speakers for gracing your important work and sharing with us your opinions. We have received overwhelming response from the entire India. We have received almost more than 1600 participation entries, and we are really thankful to all of you. Once again, I take this opportunity to thank all the delegates and speakers. Yesterday, we have requested all delegates to share their learning experience, and we are really happy to share. More than 45 participants are willing to share their feedback with us. Due to time constraint and some technical problems, they are unable to share their feedback right now online. Thank you so much.